Leisure Fabric. Myself, Rashmi Dikshit. So let us begin the session. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to analyze business needs of blockchain and they are able to explain architecture of Hyperledger. So what are ledgers? Ledgers are the key. Ledgers are the system of records for a business. Business will have multiple ledgers for multiple business networks in which they participate. There are two terminologies related to ledger: transaction and asset transfer on to or off the ledger. For example, Amar gives a car to Anthony. That is a simple transaction. And the second terminology is contract, the condition for a transaction to occur. If Anthony pays Amar money, then car passes from Amar to Anthony, a simple contract. If car won't start, funds do not pass to Amar as decided by third party. This is what somewhat complex. Now, why we need blockchain? So look at this particular pictorial representation. Customer A records, which are available at bank, auditor's place, regulations records also contain customer A records, insurer records. So where we need to keep all these records? At each and every place, which is inefficient, expensive and vulnerable. So here comes a blockchain. We can provide a solution using blockchain. Blockchain ledger, a shared, replicated, permissioned ledger with a concerns, provenance, immutability and finality. So no need to keep records at each and every place. It will act as a distributed ledger so that according to the need, each and every one will get a record from that place. So blockchain ledger, a shared, replicated and permissioned ledger. So what are the business requirements? Privacy, trust, smart contracts and shared ledger. So transactions are secure, authenticated and access controls are enabled for granular access only, that is privacy. All the transactions are verified and endorsed by trusted relevant parties, which is trust. Business logic is embedded within the database and executed to validate and store the transaction, that is smart contracts. And shared ledger, append only immutable database shared across the business network. So these four are the business requirements. Now let us see what are the properties of a distributed ledger. Decentralized, replicated across many participants, each of whom collaborate in its maintenance. Information recorded is in append mode only, immutable. And immutability makes it simple to determine the provenance of the information. And these properties make it called as systems of proofs. This is an important term, systems of proofs. Now, dear all of you, please pause the video and try to think how hyperledgers are different from Bitcoin. Take a moment or take a couple of seconds. Now check out your answer. So Hyperledger fabric provides identity. Bitcoin provides anonymity. Hyperledger fabric selective endorsement, while proof of work is present in Bitcoin. And for Hyperledger fabric, assets are there, and for Bitcoin, cryptocurrency is there. Now, what are the Hyperledger fabric key features? It is a private and permission based. Members of the Hyperledger fabric enrolls through MSP. MSP means membership service provider. Different MSPs are supported. Ledger data can be stored in multiple formats. Consensus mechanism can be switched in and out. ability to create channels, allowing a group of participants to create a separate ledger of transaction. Now check out the characteristic of Hyperledger Fabric Key: privacy and confidentiality, efficient processing, and chain code facility. So, privacy and confidentiality: restricted messaging paths that can be used to provide transaction privacy and confidentiality for a specific subset of network members. All data, including transaction member and channel information on a channel, are invisible and inaccessible to any network members does not explicitly access to that channel. Efficient processing: transaction execution is separated from transaction ordering and commitment. Division of labor unburdens ordering nodes from the demands of transaction execution and ledger maintenance, while peer nodes are freed from ordering workloads. Chain code facility: chain code applications encode logic that is invoked by special types of transaction on the channel, and system chain code is distinguished as chain code that defines the operating params for the entire channel. Now look at here the Hyperledger Fabric deployment model. Now three things are here: orderer, CA, and peer. Orderer, certified authority and peers, customer A application, merchant B application, bank application, insurer applications are running on a single platform which is accessible through peer or for that peer. Now we will see these three components one by one. So certificate authority, the first component of a fabric ledger: registration of identities or connects to LDAP as the user registry, issuance of an enrollment certificate, certificate renewal and revocation, and every single operation must be signed with a certificate. So certificate authority provides a certificate by providing a signature. The second component is a peer: can update or query the ledger. One peer can be part of multiple channels. Peer endorses the transaction. All the peers find each other and synchronize automatically. Peer manages the ledger, which consists of transaction log and world state. Peer have two roles: endorser and committer. So the peer have two roles. And the third component, orderer: before anything is committed to the ledger, it must pass through the ordered service. Provides order of transaction. It creates the blocks for the blockchain. Block size can be based on number of transaction and or timeout value. So these three are the main component of the fabric ledger. Now we will see the fabric model in detail, or what are the three things for that Hyperledger fabric model. The first one is asset: the exchange of almost anything with monetary value over the network, from whole food to antique car to currency futures, represented as a collection of key value pairs with state changes recorded as transaction on a channel ledger. Assets can be represented in binary and or JSON form. The second is chain code: defines asset or assets and the transaction instruction for modifying the asset, its business logic. Rules for reading or altering key value pairs or other state database information. Execute against the ledger's current state database and are initiated through a transaction proposal. Results in a set of key value rights that can be submitted to the network and applied to the ledger on all peers. Now we will see the third, that is ledger. One ledger per channel. Each peer maintains a copy of the ledger for each channel. Read only queries using a rich query language. Read only history queries, query ledger history for a key, enabling a data provenance scenario. Transaction contains signature of every endorsing peer and submitted to ordering service. Ledger sequence, tamper resistance record of all state transaction. Each transaction are a result of chain code invocations. Asset key value pairs that are committed to the ledger as create, update or deletes. Comprise of a blockchain to store the immutable sequence record in a block. A state database to maintain current fabric state. So, these are the references. Thank you.